Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to study carboxylic acids and their derivatives. First, we start with the introduction of carboxylic acid. So, what is carboxylic acid? These are the compounds having COOH group, and these compounds are abundant in nature where they are responsible for some familiar order. For example, here few examples are given. First, we start with the acetic acid, that is pungent in odor, and basically it smells like vinegar. Second one is butanoic acid, that is having rancid odor of sour butter. Then hexanoic acid, that is responsible for the odor of dirty socks. One more example, that is of lactic acid, that is responsible for the taste of sour milk. Carboxylic acids are also found in a wide range of pharmaceuticals that are used to treat a variety of conditions. A very common example, that is acetyl salicylic acid, that is commonly known as aspirin, and it's basically very frequently used as an analgesic. Second example, that is 4-amino salicylic acid, that is used in the treatment of tuberculosis. One more example, that is used in the acne, that is isotretinoin. Now, second part, that is the nomenclature of carboxylic acid. So basically, carboxylic acid, based on carboxylic acid present on the structure, whether it's one carboxylic group or the two carboxylic group, they are divided into two types. One is monocarboxylic acids. These are the compounds containing one carboxylic acid group named with the suffix oic acid. Basically, suffix that is used in the parent structure later on. For example, butane, 4-carbon unit structure, where E, butane, A-N-E, that is replaced with OIC, oic acid, or you can put IC, ic acid. So butane, that is converted into butanoic acid. One more example, that is 5-hydroxy-4,4-dimethylpentanoic acid. So this is the only difference, where first structure butanoic acid, that is a straight chain structure, whereas second one, that is a substituted branch chain structure. The parent is the longest chain that includes the carbon atom of carboxylic acid group. That carbon atom is always assigned number 1 when numbering the parent. When a carboxylic acid group is connected to ring, usually there are two types. One is aliphatic structure and the second one is aromatic structure. Here, first two examples that we have seen, in that carboxylic group is attached with aliphatic structure. Another example, in that carboxylic group is connected to the ring structure. That is here, one example is cyclohexane ring. Carboxylic group is attached to cyclohexane ring. And for the nomenclature of such type of compound, that is known as alkane carboxylic acid. Here alkane is nothing but cyclohexane. So you can put cyclohexane plus carboxylic acid. So the name of this compound is cyclohexane carboxylic acid. Many more examples, simple acids have common names that is accepted by IUPAC name. First we start with formic acid. Formic acid, basically it's a 1-carbon unit only, that is known as formic acid. But there are 2 carbon, then it is known as acetic acid. How we can differentiate? In first example, formic acid, you can see their H is there, but what that H is replaced with methyl group CH3, then the structure is known as acetic acid. Second, third one, that is propanoic acid, where CH3CH2COOH, that is known as propanoic acid. Then fourth example, in that 4-carbon unit structure, CH3CH2CH2COOH, that is butyric acid. And the final structure, that is aromatic structure, where COOH group is attached on benzene ring. So benzene is aromatic one, so benzene plus carboxylic acid, and that is common name is benzene carboxylic acid, but IUPAC, that is benzoic acid. Second category, that is diacids. Here name itself indicate diacids. These are the compounds containing 2 carboxylic acid groups are named with the suffix dioic acid. In the previous case, we have seen a single acid, that is eic acid, whereas here 2 acids are there, that is known as dioic acid. For example, a simple example is given. You can see on the right hand side, on the both the side, acids, functional groups are attached. Then few more examples, many diacids have common name, just like the previous. First one, that is known as oxalic acid, then second one is malonic acid, third one is succinic acid, and so on. So these are the few examples of dioic acid. Now another point, that is the structures and property of carboxylic acid. Basically, the carbon atom of carboxylic acid group is sp2 hybridized, and therefore it exhibits trigonal planar geometry with bond angle that are nearly 120 degree. Carboxylic acid can form two hydrogen bonding interaction. We all know basically hydrogen bonding, there are two types of hydrogen bonding. The first one, that is intramolecular hydrogen bonding, and the second one is intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Now, intramolecular, that is hydrogen bonding takes place in a single structure only, whereas intermolecular hydrogen bonding, where two moles require, whether they are the same one or the different one. Here two examples we have. In the first right hand side, you can see intermolecular hydrogen bonding of carboxylic acid itself. Two moles of carboxylic acid interact together via intermolecular hydrogen bonding, whereas the lower, you can see two example, one is acetic acid and ethanol. If you want to interact this two via hydrogen bonding, then that is also known as intermolecular hydrogen bonding. But this is the case where two molecules are different, whereas the first one in that two molecules of carboxylic acid, that is also possible. In this case, you can take this both butyric acid together, or you can take acetic acid and butyric acid. So such type of combinations are possible with intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Next topic, that is acidity of carboxylic acid. Now basically acidity of carboxylic acid, acid itself is acid, but acidity of that particular acid depends on the substituent present on the structure. As we know, basically there are two types of functional group. One is electron withdrawing type of functional group, and the second one is electron releasing type of group. So based on that, they withdraw electron from the structure or they release the electron, and due to that they impact on the structure, and so acidity varies from structure to structure. Here one example is given. In that example, you can see aliphatic acid is there that interact with sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide interaction, basically this reaction takes place in water, so that sodium hydroxide, that is available in ionized form. So liberated form of OH minus, ionized form OH minus, that abstract proton from substituted acid, and so water is liberated, and whatever form, that is known as carboxylate salt form. Usually salts are ionic and they are more water soluble than their parent carboxylic acid structure. Usually 95% you can say salt forms that are water soluble, but that is not the case everywhere. Few salts, they are not water soluble. Carboxylate ions are named by replacing the suffix "-ic acid" with "-ed". For example, benzoic acid you have as a parent structure, and if we give a reaction of this benzoic acid with sodium hydroxide, then what happened? Let's see. So benzoic acid plus sodium hydroxide, so that water form is liberated, and whatever form structure of salt, that is benzoic acid, COONA. So red part, that is clearly designated, from that you can replace that "-ic acid" with "-ate", that is "-ed". So what left is benzoic is converted into benzoate, and you have to attach as a prefix that sodium. So the full name is sodium benzoate, that is the final name of the structure for salt formation. This salt particularly dissolve in water. Then an equilibrium is established in which the carboxylic acid and the carboxylate ion both are present. Next is, that is carboxylic acid at physiologic pH. Generally what happens, you can see in the examples, usually all the acids are having, most of the acids, carboxylic acid having a pKa value that is between 4 and 5 most of the time. Carboxylic acids at physiologic pH, our blood is buffered to pH approximately 7.3, that is value referred to as physiological pH. When dealing with buffered solution, you may recall the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. We don't go in detail derivation and all that for this part, because these things you have already done in your first semester BPharm analysis. So we don't go beyond this, but this is just for idea how pKa value derived from, that is Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. Now second important thing, that is substituent effect on acidity. As I have already told you previously, based on the substituent present on the acid, acidity of the structure will change. So first example, that is a simple acid where pKa value 4.8, but when we go from left to right, in that case you can see the pKa value gradually down. And what is the impact of that substituent? This is the simply, in the first case there is no substitution, plain COOH, then value is 4.8. But when we go right hand side, 1 Cl, then second example, in that the 2 Cl functional group, and the lastly there are 3 Cl group. As we know that Cl belongs to halogen group, so when halogen substitution takes place single, then the value is 2.9, but there are 2 chloro, then it's 1.3, and the lastly there are 3 chloro, then value 0.9. similarly, the lower example, again it is the same. In carboxylic acid, again value 2.9, 4.9 and 4.5. This indicates clearly the effect of substituent present. And what's the reason? Halogen group that belongs to orthopara director. But though they are orthopara director, they have electron withdrawing kind of effect. So due to electron withdrawing kind of effect, it imparts more acidity to the structure than the parent plain carboxylic acid. So when we go from the single plain carboxylic acid to more substituted, or you can say monosubstituted, disubstituted or trisubstituted, in that case acidity will be increased, or you can say higher. Here in the lastly Z, red part, that is indicated as Z, that is nothing but the substituent. The clearly indicated that nitroaldehyde chloro, plain hydrogen, and the methyl substitution, in that case you can see the value of pKa. Again, nitro, that is electron withdrawing, compared to nitro, aldehyde having less electron withdrawing effect. Then go on right hand side, alkyl functional group, they are electron releasing effect, and the difference you can clearly see in this chart, in this table. Next is preparation of carboxylic acid. Now preparation of carboxylic acid, all of you know that what is preparation. Preparation is nothing but when a reactant react together, and whatever the product, final product form, that is known as the preparation. It means at the end of reaction, whatever obtained, that must be carboxylic acid, then it is known as preparation of carboxylic acid. So first example, that is hydrolysis of nitrile. Means you take nitrile as a starting material and go for hydrolysis of that nitrile, and the obtained product is acid. Simple. Then second one example, that is a benzyl bromide, then that will interact with cyanide, so that cyanide easily replace bromide, because bromide, that is a good living group, so that cyanide, benzyl cyanide is formed. That cyanide group interact with water and heat, means hydrolysis takes place, so that benzyl cyanide is converted into phenyl acetic acid. Another example, carboxylation of Grignard reagent. Again, it's like a previous one, that is benzyl bromide. Here it is simply plain bromobenzene, that is interact with magnesium, and that will form magnesium bromide, a Grignard reagent, that is further interact with carbon dioxide and water, that will form benzoic acid. Next is reactions of carboxylic acid. Reactions, it means during the reaction carboxylic acid is involved for further reaction, that is known as reactions of carboxylic acid. A very first example, that is a type of reduction reaction, means reduction of carboxylic acid. That reaction takes place in presence of LAH and water, means first step, that is reduction takes place, and subsequently it undergoes hydrolysis. LAH is nothing but it is known as lithium aluminium hydride, that is LiAlH4. So here mechanism is shown, that how carboxylic acid interact with LiLH4 and reduction takes place. Under such conditions, the aldehyde cannot be isolated. You can see at the end of reaction aldehyde is formed, but that aldehyde is not the stable one, it's the very reactive one, so that it cannot be isolated. So what happened, that is further undergo reaction with the same LH4 and interact with that will form a final structure of hydrocarbon. Under such condition, the aldehyde cannot be isolated. Instead, it is further attacked by LAH to form an alkoxide, which is then protonated with H3O+. is introduced into the reaction flask. An alternative method for reducing carboxylic acid that involves the use of borane, that is BH3. If you remember, in this semester, Ruchi madam has taken various reactions like involving reducing agent like sodium borohydride, LiH4, LiAlH4, and boron hydride. So in that, these are the agent that is mainly used for the reduction. So another example, that is with BH3. Then next is carboxylic, introduction to carboxylic acid derivatives. So here, simple introduction part. In the previous section, we learn about the reaction between a carboxylic acid and LiH. This reaction is a reduction because the carbon atom of the carboxylic acid group is reduced in the process, right? Now, derivative part. Here in your, you can see there are basic four derivatives of carboxylic acid, that are acid halides, acid anhydride, ester and amide. In the first case, you can see RCOOH. It means, RCOOH. In that OH, that is replaced because OH is a good leaving group, and that is replaced with Cl. Then it is known as acid chloride. If OH, that is replaced with O, COOR, then it is known as acid anhydride. When that OH is replaced with OR, then it is known as ester. And similarly, that OH replaced with NH2, then it is known as amide. So these four are the basic derivatives. Apart from that, cyanide or and nitrile, that is also involved in some of the textbook. The nitrile, that is the derivative of carboxylic acid. Next is the nomenclature of this derivative. The first, we start with naming acid halides. Acid halides are named as derivative of carboxylic acid by replacing suffix, that is ic acid, that is with YL halide. Here you can see a clear example. Suppose we have taken acetic acid and OH, acetic acid, in that ic acid, a highlighted red color highlighted part, that we replace with YL halide. Here halide is nothing but the bromine, so that is YL bromide. So it is, now it gets converted into acetic acid to acetyl bromide. Similarly, another example, that is with aromatic structure, in that benzoic acid, ic acid, that is replaced with YL. So benzoic is first converted into benzyl, but OH, suppose that is we replace with chloride. So in that case, what happened? Benzoyl chloride. When an acid halide group is connected to a ring, the suffix carboxylic acid is replaced with carbonyl halide. This is something different way. One example, that cyclohexane ring is there. It's carboxylic acid, it is attached. Then the name of this structure is cyclohexane carboxylic acid. If this OH, that is replaced with Cl, then the name would be carboxylic, that is converted into carbonyl, and OH replaced with Cl, that's why it is known as what? Carbonyl chloride, cyclohexane carbonyl chloride. This is the name of this compound. Second one, naming acid anhydride. Acid anhydrides are named as a derivative of carboxylic acid by replacing suffix, that is acid, with anhydride. One example, that is acetic anhydride, acid, that is replaced with anhydride. So the name would be acetic anhydride. Similarly, another example, succinic acid. So acid drops and word anhydride is added, that is known as succinic anhydride. Another example, that is very interesting one, asymmetric anhydrides are there. Then what we should do in that case, two different carboxylic acids are there and name given by both acid, and usually it is by alphabetically followed by the suffix anhydride. Here in this case, simply you split the structure with O, and then you have a two different part. One is benzoic acid, benzene ring, COOH, and the right hand side, that is CA3COOH. It means it's a fusion of acetic acid and benzoic acid. So as per alphabetical order, acetic acid come first and then benzoic. So the name would be, it is acetic then benzoic anhydride. So it is acetic benzo anhydride. Next is naming esters. Esters are named by first indicating the alkyl group attached to the oxygen atom, followed by carboxylic acid, for which the suffix ic acid is replaced with ate, A-T-E. Here in example, red color part eic acid that is replaced with ATE, so that acetic acid gets converted into acetate. Here highlighted green color highlighted part, that is the substitution. It means ethyl group is present. So the name would be ethyl acetate. Another example, malonic acid. In that case, same way, eic acid that is dropped and it is converted into ad, known as malonic, gets converted into malonate. But here substitution, there are two substitution from both the side, that is highlighted with the green part, that is ethyl. So it is known as diethyl malonate. The same methodology is applied when the ester group is connected to ring, for example. The same way it is cyclohexane carboxylic acid that is converted into carboxylate. And which carboxylate? This is methane, right? Next is naming amide. Amides are named as derivative of carboxylic acids by replacing the suffix eic acid, that is with amide. One example, acetic acid gets converted into amide. This same way that we have used for the previous examples. Likewise, when the amide group is connected to a ring structure, then suffix carboxylic acid replaced with carboxylate amide. If the nitrogen atom bears alkyl groups, then these groups are indicated at the beginning of the letter N, is used as a locant to indicate that they are attached to the nitrogen. For example, here you can see in the first case, that is Ca3COONHCH3. In that case, you can see two substituent, one substituent methyl group, whereas one is hydrogen. So here you can write N-methyl. Whereas in second case, you can see there are two methyl groups attached on nitrogen. That's why it is known as N-N-dimethyl. So in this way, we can give the name to amide when where substitution present on nitrogen, particularly alkyl functional groups. Next is naming nitrile. Nitriles are named as derivative of carboxylic acids by replacing the suffix eic acid, or either you can put oic acid with O nitrile. Example is acetic acid gets converted into O nitrile. It means acetic acid to acetonitrile. Second example, that is benzoic acid to benzonitrile. Here we end our session. I think this is sufficient for today. Here I have given few examples for the practice as well as for the nomenclature point of view. So please you go through with this, and if you have any doubts and query, you can ask me anytime, and feel free to contact me. Thank you.